Hello everyone, today's video is all about VAT and specifically what's known as the option to tax on commercial property. So what is option to tax? Well, option to tax is essentially when you turn an exempt supply into a taxable supply for VAT purposes. So the default position on commercial buildings is that when you make a supply of that building, not from the building, but of the building, such as selling the building or renting the building, then the default position is you don't charge VAT. However, if you make what is called an option to tax election on the building, you're essentially telling HMRC that instead of it being exempt, it will now be subject to VAT and you will charge VAT on the supplies of that building, such as the rent and the sale of the building. Now, why would you choose to voluntarily opt to tax a building? So the principal reason you would do that is to recover VAT on the costs of the building. So for example, if you bought the commercial building and VAT has been charged, then you may elect to opt to tax the building to cover, to reclaim the VAT on the purchase price. However, you don't need to in all examples. So VAT and property at the best of times is quite tricky, but option to tax is even more trickier. So let me give you some examples. So supposing you buy a new commercial building and VAT has been charged on it. So let's say it's £1 million, £1 million plus VAT. So that is £200,000 of VAT that you have incurred. Now, supposing you buy that as a property investor and your intention with that commercial building is to let it out. So the default position on commercial property is that no VAT is charged. So someone who sold you the building has either opted to tax the building, or if it's brand new, if it's within 3 years old, the standard position is it's you have to pay VAT on the purchase price. But going forward, you don't have to charge VAT on the rent to your tenants. So you bought this £1 million building plus VAT, and your intention is to let it out to some tenants. Okay, that is an exempt supply, the letting out of to the tenants. And you cannot claim VAT back when you make exempt supplies. So that 200 grand that you've suffered when you bought the building for £1 million plus VAT, you cannot claim that 200 grand back from HMRC as input VAT because you are not charging any VAT to your tenants. It's an exempt supply. So this is a reason why you would choose to opt to tax. You make an election. Basically, you say to the tax man, we will turn this from an exempt supply to a taxable supply and we will charge the tenants VAT. Principally, you do that because then you can reclaim the 200 grand back on the purchase price. So by charging VAT on the future supplies of the building, i.e. the rent, that enables you to claw back the VAT on the purchase price. So that's fundamentally why you would choose to make the option to tax. Now then, your tenants, if they are fully taxable businesses themselves, they will then be able to claim back the VAT that you charge on the rent on their VAT returns. The only circumstances where that will be an extra cost to them than if you hadn't have opted to tax is if, say, they themselves were exempt businesses and they were making non-VATable supplies, such as an insurance company or a bank. Those types of businesses don't charge VAT themselves, so they can't claim VAT back on their supplies. But in most commercial circumstances, when you're letting out commercial property, I would suggest that the vast majority of tenants are fully VATable businesses, which will be able to claim back the VAT element of the rent you charge them. So that's the first reason why you'd opt to tax a property, so you can claim the VAT back on the purchase price, which can be quite a significant figure. So let's have a look at the second example. The second example, let's assume similar expense this time, £1 million commercial property bought plus 200 grand VAT, but this time you are buying it as a widget manufacturer and you are buying the commercial building, not to let out, but to use in your own trade. So you will trade your widget manufacturing business from the commercial property. Now, you've been charged 200 grand VAT. In this case, you don't need to opt to tax the property to claim the VAT back because you are not making exempt supplies of the building. You are not charging rents to tenants. You are making taxable supplies from the building. So there's a crucial difference. Your widget business, of which you charge VAT to your customers, that is, you are making taxable supplies from the building, not of the building, but that is crucial. But it still enables you to claim back the 200 grand input VAT that you suffered when you bought the building, the fact that you are making taxable supplies from the building. So you don't need to opt to tax the building to claim the £200,000 VAT back. You just claim it back as normal on your next VAT return the quarter after you've bought the building. And many people get that wrong and they assume that they always have to opt to tax the building whenever they've been charged VAT when they buy the building. Well, you don't have to. If you are in that scenario, you're using the building for your commercial business, you're trading from the building, you don't need to opt to tax the building. However, down the line, you may need to because elsewhere in the VAT code is a separate piece of legislation called the Capital Goods Scheme. And the Capital Goods Scheme says that if you sell a commercial building within 10 years and you're making exempt supplies, some of the input VAT that you've claimed will be clawed back. Now, I've just said you're not making any supplies of the building in that circumstance, the widget maker. They're making taxable supplies, making widgets. However, if let's say they need to expand to bigger premises after 5 years, find a bigger site, and they sell the building, at that point, they are making supplies of the building. Now, in that instance, it is an exempt supply because they haven't opted to tax, because I've just said you don't need to opt to tax, you claim the VAT back anyway. So in 5 years' time, they come to sell the building with no VAT added, because they've sold it within 10 years of buying it, HMRC say, actually, when you sell the building, that's an exempt supply. You claim 200 grand of VAT 5 years ago, we'll have half of that clawed back, thank you very much. I.e. 5 years divided by 10 in that 10-year window for the capital goods scheme. So you don't want that. So what do? So then you would choose to opt to tax the property at that point. In other words, you make the election just before you sell the building, which means that you would charge VAT on the sale of the building to whoever you're selling it to, and that enables you not to have to have any of the input VAT from 5 years previously clawed back. So VAT, fraught with issues, property in particular, option to tax especially so. So as you can see, there's reasons why you would have to charge, you would have to opt to tax the property. There's instances where you may do, and there's instances where you don't have to. So it is a minefield. You do need to speak to someone with regards to VAT. And often we see in the VAT world, people come to this too late. So they've done some of these things and not realized the problem, particularly on that last example. So with the person who sold, the company who sold their commercial property within the 10-year window and didn't add VAT because they thought, well, look, it's an exempt supply. But the fact that they clawed VAT back all those years earlier and it's within 10 years, they don't realize you have to repay that. And they've gone and sold it without charging VAT, where all they had to do was opt to tax, charge the VAT, and then yes, hopefully the buyer can then claim it back themselves. So all sorts of issues. Another issue on option to tax is What if you are acquiring the building from the seller and you are acquiring it with tenants in situ? So let's say, you know, you might be using it for some of your own, to trade from your own business in it, or part of the building you will carry on being a landlord that the previous owner was, and charge rents on tenants in the building. Now, under certain circumstances, that qualifies for what's known in the VAT world as a transfer of a going concern. And you, as long as you opt to tax the building before you acquire it from the seller, because you are taking on a property rental business, the seller doesn't have to charge VAT on the sale. So even though you could have claimed it back anyway on your next VAT return, it's still a cash flow issue, particularly in that example of 1 million. 200 grand is a lot, even though you're going to get it back from HMRC, but it might be 3 or 4 months later. So under certain circumstances, even though the seller has opted to tax and therefore should charge you the VAT on the sale, if you have this rental business that you are acquiring, then the seller doesn't have to charge you the VAT. Good for cash flow, even if you could have claimed it back down the line in any case. So have a think about that. What is the nature of the building I'm acquiring? Am I acquiring it purely to trade out of? Am I acquiring it as an investment? Am I acquiring it with both tenants in situ and to trade out of as well? So option to tax, all sorts of details. That's just a quick overview, but do speak to someone about VAT, specifically VAT recovery, because often I've seen a lot of people over the years get this wrong and they cannot claim back often tens or hundreds of thousands of pounds worth of VAT because they've got the steps and the paperwork wrong. So do think about VAT and this whole option to tax on commercial property. Doesn't apply to residential property. Residential property a lot easier when it comes to VAT. It's exempt supplies, unless you're a new home builder and you make what's known as a zero rated supply. But all this choice about should I opt or not, should I turn it from an exempt into a standard supply for VAT, doesn't apply in the residential sector. This is just for commercial properties. So if you like this video, please do subscribe and I will see you soon.